Resend just had a huge launch week where we introduced inbound and then a bunch of stuff for both transactional and marketing emails. I don't know about you, but whenever I see new features in a product that I use and love, I want to know, how do I implement those and what are the advantages for me? So that's what I want to talk about in today's video. You ready? Let's go. So in today's video, we're not going to talk about inbound. We're mostly going to talk about transactional and marketing emails as they affect your current flow. So how do you implement these new features and what are the advantages for you? I've got this sample project with a newsletter card and an account card just to kind of mimic different flows you might have in your application. So you can see here somebody can sign up for a newsletter or they can create an account. And either way, they should receive an email confirmation using React email that then templates that out to them and sends them a personalized email. So all this is how you probably have something set up right now. So let's dive into the code a little bit more to see what we're currently doing. And then we'll talk about some of the disadvantages that we tried to fix with a lot of these new features. So jump over here, you can see I've got this newsletter card, and it simply uses use action state from React, where I've got this action that sends them a confirmation email. So I grab their email to make sure I actually have it, and I want to do a few things. First of all, I add them as a contact in Resend using audiences. We'll talk about segments, which is one of these new things in a moment here. And then you can see that down here, I simply send them a confirmation email. Now it comes from my custom domain. I'm assuming you have this set up if you're already a Resend customer, to their email, and then it simply sends them this React email code. Now I can preview this right here, not only obviously in the code, but I can actually jump over to the local dev server I have running and see all this as well. Now, this is great. This works really well, and it still works today. So if I jump over here, nothing is broken. I can say chris@resend.com, hit send. It should send me that email, and I'll get a confirmation here. And if I jump back over here to my email inbox, there we go. I get the email very quickly. Okay, so everything is working as expected. I've made no changes to my code base, but let's talk about some of the disadvantages in this current flow. It requires separate dev commands for my local repo and then also for React email. It also requires technical knowledge to update these templates. And there's no review process or team collaboration. There's no version control, and non-technical users, again, are reliant upon a developer, which means things can kind of get stacked up. So we also haven't really talked about user experience. This would be your customers receiving your emails. Wouldn't it be nice if you could give them granular permissions over which items they receive from you and then have a global view of everything you're interacting with? And the templates themselves, rather than sending along the entire React in the payload, wouldn't it be great if you could send along an ID and simply reference a template you already have existing? So a lot of this is what we're going to talk about today in upgrading this kind of old way of thinking to the new way of thinking. Let's start by uploading templates to Resend. You see here I've got a newsletter sign up, and I've also got this account creation flow. So we have these two, which we've already seen in React email over this way. We've added a new tab called Resend down here, and this allows you to very quickly upload all of your React email templates to Resend, to your Resend account. So I'm going to jump back over to my terminal. I'll close down the dev server, and then I simply want to run that command npx React email latest Resend setup. What this does is it requires you to have an API key, and then you give it that API key and it encrypts it locally in your machine, and you can use that to upload templates to your account. So now let's jump over to our code, and I've got a .env file. I'll obviously delete this before you see it, but let's grab this Resend API key and let's add it in over here. So this has full access. Everything should be working as expected. I'll get it back up and running with my npm run dev command, and then I'll jump over here and refresh, and I should see now the opportunity both to upload or to bulk upload templates. So upload just sends one template up, bulk upload is going to send them both up. So I'll send both of these up. You'll see it sends up one and then the other, and I can actually open them directly in Resend. It's not just there as static content, it's interactive. So I can actually change stuff if I want to. All these blocks can move around as well. Designers, developers, marketers alike can all work together as a team. Now, once I add some kind of from and a subject, maybe we can use the new preview text and alt text that's done by AI, kind of intelligently trying to grab your existing voice and tone and all that and adding it in here. Okay, so we've got this set and ready to go. Once I want to use it, I just simply need to publish the template. So whenever you want to use a template, it needs to be published first, and that tells Resend this one's ready to go. And as I make changes, I can decide when I want to then publish the next version. So as I start to work on this again, you'll notice that then it's back in a draft state marked by this little blue dot. And once I'm ready, I can then update this again. Now, obviously I don't want to do that. So we're happy with the existing flow, and I'll come back out to my templates. Now to reference this, I simply need to reference either the alias or the actual ID of the template. So the alias is right here. I can also grab it by viewing the details and grabbing it right here. Or of course I can grab the ID from the URL as well. All right, so back over in the code here, instead of using React email here to send along React as the payload, I'm going to replace all of this and with the template like this. And this takes two things. It has the ID, that's what we just copied, so let's paste that in here. And then if we had variables, we could also add them there, which we'll talk about in a second. But for now, just know that I can hook this up, send along an ID, I don't have to send along the entire payload from my React email, and it will actually grab all that, interpret it, send out that specific email. So let's now test this form. So if I come back over here, I can now say chris@resend.com. Maybe we'll just add this like plus new just to know it's something different, and I'll click sign up. I should send this out and it will reference that published template, the last version of that template to send out the email. So I can come over here to my newsletter and let's get rid of this one. Let's see. And here's the next one and looks, it sent it to me and it sent it to Chris plus new. So I know it's actually using the template. I just had to send along the template ID. And again, now I can collaborate together on this template in real time. So let's say I wanted to come back to my template, wherever that's at, right over here, and I want to actually update this. So I could update it, make changes directly in here, and the next time I reference this, assuming I published the version, it will send out the new published version. This means you can iterate on templates in real time as a team, and multiple people can actually work on this together. I can show you that actually by opening a separate tab with the same exact thing. And notice now I've got two Chris's, myself and my other self. All right, two of us are in here working on this. As I make changes, you can view the version right here. Each published version, you can restore previous versions. It's a lot of powerful stuff under the hood. You'll notice here I've got the from and the preview and the subject text all here as well. Now, when I send the payload, I don't have to include these, but I can if I want to. Anytime you send that payload, it will override the from and the subject as well. So if I don't like those kind of fallbacks I have, I can come over here and add my own right here. But I also don't have to add these anymore because the template itself handles all that. So I could just send along the to and the template ID, and that's it. And all the rest of it lives in my template. Now, audiences are now segments. In fact, I'll show you that in the dashboard. You'll see under my audience, I've got contacts. So these are global contacts. We also have segments. These segments are our old audiences. And this is actually where this page defaults to, just so you know kind of where everything lives. And all your existing code continues to work as it used to. But what this allows you to do is to have business segmentation under segments, and then you can have topics that allow people to opt in or opt out of things when they click unsubscribe. So it used to be that if they unsubscribed from that audience, but there was no real control for a user to say, I don't want anything from these people, or I want additional items from this company. Like, ooh, I kind of want the monthly newsletter, or I don't want this, but I do want that. So this allows you to kind of have that full experience, and you can even customize this page, which you could always do, but we've just made it a little bit easier. Now notice there's a couple things here. We've got opt out and opt in by default. What this means is if it's opt in by default, every new contact you add will automatically be opted into this topic. Opt out by default means they will not be opted in. You have to manually opt them in. Let's go back to our newsletter sign up, and I wanna look at the actual flow here. You'll notice I'm not actually adding the topic here, and that's because it was opt in by default. So you may want to come down here, and if you don't want your newsletter to be opt in, you might have to add the user to a topic. So we'll talk about how to do that, and then you'd send a confirmation email. So how would you actually add a user to a topic? You do that either from the UI right here, so I could come inside here, edit the contact, and then change which topics that they are subscribed to. These are the ones that they will now see when they go to the unsubscribe page if they're private, for instance. And then I could also do this from the API. So if I come over here, you can create a contact, get a contact, or here in this case, update a contact. Now, there's also another tag here for visibility, private or public. This just means, does it show on the customized unsubscribe page? So if I mark one of these as private, so let's come in here, we can actually change a couple things about this. One of the things we can change is its visibility. You'll notice it disappears from my custom unsubscribe page. So now whenever I send out a newsletter, like here I am in my broadcast here, so I've added them to my resend audience. I now want to send out a newsletter. This is more of a marketing feature. I then want to select a topic, and I want to say only send this to people who have opted in or are still opted in to my monthly newsletter. So only those people will get it within this particular audience. In this case, I'm sending it to previous purchasers. So you can see how we now have like more granular control, both from a user perspective, from your perspective, to be able to decide who you want to send things to and give them granular user permissions. But also for a recipient, they can decide, I don't want this, but I actually do want this from this company. And on top of that, you have global views into the actual contact. I can see every single thing I've done from a marketing perspective for them, which segments, which topics, all of that is included in this activity view. Now, we haven't even talked about some of the new options for contacts like custom properties. We'll have to leave that for another video. But next, let's actually get our other template up because it's got one other thing I want to talk about, which is template variables. You'll notice that this new account flow actually adds in the username directly in the email itself. So when I see this in my templates editor, you'll see I've got this kind of stand-in right here that simply says custom username. Obviously, I want this to be a real variable and not just a hard-coded value here. So you can now actually add variables inside of templates for transactional type emails. And if I come in here, I can search for variable, or I can also use those open curly braces as well and create a new variable. Now, there are a couple of words that are reserved here, and these are mostly things that were connected to like a contact in the past, like email and first name and last name and unsubscribe URL. But here I'm going to add something like username. That's very important. This is case sensitive. So whatever you name it here, you have to name it that in your code as well. Keep it as a type of string. And for the custom fallback value, we'll do like your username. Now, you don't have to have anything there, but you can, and sometimes it can be useful. So I'll go ahead and create this variable, and it adds it directly in here. If I don't send along something in the payload, it will just use whatever the fallback value was, like your username here. So now let's also make sure we add a from subject. This will work. Let's add both of these just using AI. And now I'll go ahead and publish this template. I've got a couple of warnings. Nope, they're gone. Okay, good. So let's publish this. And now we should be ready to use this. So what I want to do is, instead of using React, I'm going to use a template, and we're going to pass along two things this time. We've got both the ID. Now we just copied that. That's our alias, or it can be the actual ID of the template from the URL as well. And then we'll also have a variables object here. This is simply key value pairs. Again, I have to name this exactly what I named it in the editor, which is username. And of course, you can do all this through the API as well. If you want to set up, create templates through the API, you can do that as well. So that's all the code change we need. I sent along a custom variable that will then be interpreted by Resend and sent along with the template. So I'll come back over here. Let's add like Chris1, I don't know. And then email will be Chris. Let's do it like plus account just to know it's different at resend.com. And then we'll have some kind of password that doesn't matter. All right, and I'll create the account. Now, what this will do is it will create an account for me and then send me a confirmation email using my template. So I can check this again if I jump back over this way. Let's delete this newsletter, and here we go. Account created already. Show images, and here we go. So we've got my custom username that I passed along. There's the variable right here, and everything is working as expected. So just swapping out a couple of things can really upgrade your experience. And again, the best part is, if I ever want to update these templates, I don't have to do any code changes. Somebody else could do that, publish it, and the new published version will be used the next time I send it out. But I can continue to iterate together with my team in real time. So templates, this global context model, topics, and then the React email to resend flow, all these things are meant to make your life a lot easier, give you more control and more personalization over the emails that you send. Well, if you have any questions about this or any of the other features we launched, let me know down below. Thanks so much for watching. We'll catch you in the next one. Happy emailing.